Greetings. Hello, welcome back to some more Long of the Chosen. It is time to start liberating our third region and its Operation Silent Spark? Yeah, I don't think so. Now, it seems someone here was very confident in sending four people on this mission. Expect hostile resistance. Oh, we're not getting any pictures for the Spark. I have to see about that. So, yeah, I'm still a little bit bummed about losing one soldier in the last mission, but you know what? Given the odds of that mission, I should probably be happy that four people made it out alive, and that three even made it out uninjured. Anyway,
confirmed coordinates. We have eyes on the target.
Right, as we have vigilance active, and I'm scouting with someone who doesn't have reduced detection range. What am I doing here? Oh yeah, you don't have Trojan, but you do have combat protocol. But that's not gonna be well. I've never seen it actually do the 5 damage that it's claiming that it can do there.
Cover me.
Anyway, let's just run a little bit closer. What interesting squad setup I used here. Okay, we've got a grenadier, which is not going to be able to shoot, but at least he has grenades and is an officer. We've got the Spark.
Double time.
And we've got our Overwatch Ranger here. I think at this point our only Overwatch Ranger.
Certainly gonna put in a good word for you if we make it out of here.
Okay, so how does the concealment with the Spark work? I think he still takes cover, so I'm just not sure if half cover works to stay hidden from a drone or something. Let's just I'm not even sure which voice back we have active for the Spark, and he just accepted that move order without any voice playing. Alright. That's what we're gonna do today, huh? Get stuck in the first drone and have to open up on it. Alright, so yeah, you're on the detection tile, but of course you don't have line of sight. Did I bring AP rounds? No, not even that. I guess we're gonna activate. I guess we're gonna go loud here. I'm gonna just move up in the process.
Damn it.
Excuse me, I was going to shotgun you. I can't just fly away. It's incredibly rude. Supply cache. Yes. We're gonna make sure to probably hack that on the way out or so. Let's see if we can actually roll that 5 damage.
No idea what this thing is.
Why is it still showing the loot? I saw the text here that we picked it up. Which also might mean that I still need to double check on the reliable ever vigilant mod. Because I'm thinking that after picking up the loot, you're probably not gonna get the automatic Overwatch. So there was no weapon fire here whatsoever, so there shouldn't be any enemies on yellow alert.
I'm on my way.
That's a default Spark voice back. How is Lana's side looking here? Kind of. Part of me wants to overwatch, part of me just wants to move closer. Unless there's enemies in there, which I don't think there is, let's just get in there.
In motion.
Roger that. Scanning. I mean, I saw we picked up some icon. He made the voice line of picking up an item, so I'm just gonna ignore this, especially since also the timer is not taking down. XCOM is a flawless game without any bugs. What are you talking about? Anyway.
Yes, Commander. Contact.
Okay. Looks like we found somebody. We caught teamwork to get here. And then we still have an action to shotgun him in the face. That means we need to get rid of that guardian. Let's overdrive 2 again. Free actions this turn, no actions turn ending. So same thing, I could overdrive to get into a flanking position and shoot the guardian. I'm just not sure if I have enough damage to get through 9 HP. Also run you for an ever vigilant flank.
Moving on target.
Okay, first of all, what damage does my weapon do? 6 to 9. It's a bloody long cooldown on that ability, not gonna lie. Alright, let's just get point blank on that guy and activate a whole bunch more. Alright, okay. Well, turns out. Where's the objective? Back there on the table? Okay, cool. Turns out it's time to activate the Silent Spark. So far, so good. So far, so good. So way too much still alive here. I'm trying to see if I can find a spot where I can hack the mech. I'm not having very high hopes about that. Okay, um run in from ever vigilant against the mech. Not gonna do too much though. Let's see this way. We have 5 points of ability. If we've got armor, we've got 12 HP, we can take a shot of the mech. Just gonna see what we can do about that guardian and about that other guy. I'm gonna get one shot on Overwatch if I run in there with ever vigilant. Unlikely to kill the mech. I'm somewhat okay likely to kill the trooper. But I gotta make sure that I'm not wasting my shot on someone else then. And that all depends really on who moves first. But first things first. Rapid deploy, flashbang on these two jerks. Yeah.
Grenade out.
I actually think my best action is to command here and take a shot at the mech. That's my best way to potentially killing him. You can't command a spark. What? Excuse me? How does that make any sense? It's a machine, I should be able to give it orders. Okay. Let's just get over here. Get a shot, a free shot on the mech. We're gonna lob a grenade on this jerk.
Have some.
Now, the Guardian is still flanking me here, so. Although, I'm not sure. Yeah, like an XCOM 1, he shouldn't be able to lean out because I've got a unit standing there, but that doesn't happen in this game. So I'm thinking we're gonna eat protocol. Well, better is obvious, probably to just teamwork, you're out of position, and we... pop this guy. And we'll see just how resilient a mech is. A spark. Part of me kinda wants to go in there just so that this guy is more likely to micro-missile instead of shooting. Do I have Field Surgeon? I do. Then again, this guy could also... Well, he's flashbanged, he can't run in here to shoot me. Can he? And who knows, maybe he micro-missiles. Or maybe he doesn't do any of that.
Permission to approach.
He can actually flank me there, no problem. Except that he misses a 91. Sorry.
Get down here! Not fair if I have all the fun.
That's a little bit overwatch heavy there, buddies. Could you not? Oh, I'm flanked by those guys. Okay. Could get the objective. I also wanted to really throw an evac last turn. Let's throw it this turn then.
Emergency evacuation requested.
This is Firebrand. Evac request confirmed. Hold tight.
Could flashbang, but still you're flanked. Have decent shots on those guys. I guess I could just take one shot to clear one of the overwatches, run the other. Grenade outside and not hit anybody, that's good. On this side can blow up those three civilians. I will teach them. Trying to figure out how I can get everybody kind of sorted out here this turn. I want to flashbang these guys, but I, for obvious reasons, don't want to run two overwatches here. And I don't want to keep sitting in half cover. So I could flashbang them, then grenade them, and shoot them with the mech, but then we have a guardian in our midst, and that's also not nice. The solution to dealing with the guardian is probably running in here and then receiving a command and shooting him. That's gonna be not be enough. 9 damage with a ballistic shotgun is somewhat unlikely. But let's move here first. You know, that new Overwatch system they introduced for this version of Long War of the Chosen, like one of the advantages of the great new Overwatch system was that at least now the indicators from Gotcha, whether or not you trigger Overwatch, they're correct now, you know. Not my text, that's what they said. Turns out they are like reasonably not correct. Okay, so we're gonna run overwatches here, I guess. Maybe.
Yeah. Servos engaged.
Get you inside. Not even close.
Minor damage.
Seriously? Oh, it's going well.
Approaching target now.
It's all going well here.
I demand answers.
So now we have to rely on actually doing 6 damage here with the shotgun. Well, I didn't even put any attachments on that thing. Don't you wish you could command a spark? Not even close.
Get down.
Diagnostics assessing damage.
I would have not expected this outcome. And I don't think that was so intriguing. How was he able to even see me there? Oh, it's one of those situations. I can shoot you, but you can't shoot me. What is happening? Are you a Long War One floater? Well, on the bright side, that jerk is in a terrible position and we can just shoot him. Well, we can shoot everybody, but we can actually flank and shoot him. I think we're gonna do that first.
Affirmative.
Switch one tile over. 100%. Still a 7% chance to graze, so you know that's gonna be a graze here.
Sir, I have visual on the object. Drinks are on permission to approach.
Can I get that little cover thing to actually show up red? Ideally without killing the civilians in the process. Why does the game think it needs to make this invisible to me? It's like, no, no, that's not what I'm trying to do here. Okay, let's be realistic. Long War 2 covered instruction will never destroy this thing. Not without at least Zappa or probably Combat Engineer.
Chew on this.
Let's get some high ground.
Movement request confirmed.
You did what? It's just, it's okay. It's your own position. That's all that matters. 54. So I could run in Jason somewhere and just take a random shot here to get 5 more aim, right? Because of the focus fire. I'm not sure that's going to be worth it. I think I'd rather H protocol up here. If that's still needed. I mean, we can just get the kill here.
Target still standing.
I'm kind of hoping he does AoE suppression. Like the good gunner he is. I can hack the objective from here. Let's go here. I can hack the objective from there. I can hack the tower from there. McLoot. Yeah, okay, we were never gonna get that.
Stick together!
Detecting system damage.
That's getting quite annoying. The rarely mentioned elbow laser of the Spark may have taken shots here.
Negative.
Hmm. I don't really see an option other than to just continue taking shots here. I guess I could have gone for a run into an ever vigilant flank.
Position confirmed.
Pick up that loot here next turn. I know we have one more grenade on Jason. Maybe we can, if that's not enough here. Okay. Yeah, loot destroyed, but I didn't want to take the risk of having the Spark standing up, taking another shot here. That's going to be enough repair time as is. Alright, there could be one more solo drone. I don't worry too much about this. So let's do the hack.
I'm on it.
We've got mech weapons and we don't, we're not building enough. We've got upgraded armor and we have built two so far. I think supplies is still our biggest thing that's missing. Our two new rebels is kind of tempting, but no, let's take the higher risk, higher chance here. Right. Never would have made the resistance broadcast anyway.
Successful acquisition of the advent files. Eliminate any remaining hostiles in the
area. I should have done this hack first. Because you cannot get the same reward twice, right? And if I got the supplies from this one, I could have gone for the other one. Yes, we'll go for an advanced PCS and fail it. Alright. Cool, cool, cool. Still alien turn. Okay. Solid that means copy. There is a solo drone out there.
Double time it. Ready to fire.
Mark! Stay alert!
Overwatch mode active. Additional contacts on approach.
That's fine. We're gonna be out next turn. There's something really weird going on. That animation didn't look right.
Scanning. Bangs out.
Engaging. Overwatch.
Hold the line.
Dropping in behind me. Ish. The mech. Let's just leave.
Nearing strike range.
We need to stick together.
Moving as ordered.
Do we take parting shots? Of course we do. Right. It's not just about leaving the mission, it's about sending a message.
apologize for your untimely death. Requires reloading.
Nothing's moving down there.
What were those shots? Maybe just like... Yeah, okay, good. Let's just leave. I did not expect that, that stun lancer kill there. Not at all, not in a million years. Took a little bit of damage, but you know what? Got a good shredder gun off, and that's all that counts.
Recent attacks by dissident elements operating outside of the city centers have done little to slow the progress of Advent's ongoing development or outreach programs. Voluntary citizen emigration numbers are reportedly at their highest level in recent years.
Not the most damage. I guess the Spark did some good things here.
Well done, Commander. It's always good for morale when we ace a mission like that.
I really do like triggering overdrive, and then you get, if you have targets, free shots at them, and then you kind of need adaptive aim to make sure that you don't get any aim penalties. I'm not sure yet how I want to build this spark. Like, overall, I always see them more as an offensive tool than rather as a tanky tool. Yeah, let's get adaptive aim. I'm thinking we might build a second spark if our supplies allow it at some point, and then we can try the more tanky option. Over here. Well, that's gotta be Trojan, right? Yeah, always tempted. Medical protocol is such nice. You know, it's a good ability. But Trojan is so good at making Hex, like, more reliable. Or even you can... usually then kill a drone just by hacking it. You shut it down and it dies once it wakes back up. Okay, got that. Got some extra intel. 85 intel, that's really looking good. So as I was saying last episode, I'm gonna spend some time building squads now. Now everybody should be kind of home, nobody's infiltrating. We still have two people out on covert action for 10 more hours. And you are obviously on sharpshooter training for 48 hours, but that's not a big deal. So in case you're wondering about squads, they are here. They don't really have any effect. It's really just well, it's making it easier to like get a squad for the mission, because then in the mission setup you just say I want squad A, squad B, and then you get immediately a bunch of soldiers selected. I don't have to search, okay, who's your teamwork buddy, I want to bring you together, etc. Because even with the color-coded bonds that I have, well, game's running out of colors, so yeah, so it's not that easy to see always. The other thing is obviously for kind of roleplay reasons, having the same squad together, and then you can also build them around certain tasks. Like one first thing I'm gonna have to consider here is that we will we're gonna have a network tower coming in soon. So network tower is something, let me just, you know, let me create a squad. We'll have to think about the network tower. So one squad will be probably built around the network tower team, but obviously they also do other missions. So for network tower I usually want to have a a stealthy shinobi who can get in there and press the button. So network tower missions, just to go one step further here, bear with me. In case you haven't seen in Long War 2, Long War of the Chosen Network Tower, you have to kill all the enemies and you have to press the button on the end. It's like the normal network tower in vanilla XCOM 2. Problem is, you get constant reinforcements until you press the button, so pressing the button kinda important if you want to kill all the enemies, because otherwise for unlimited reinforcements that's kinda hard. Additionally, when you press the button, all enemies get stunned for 2 turns, or rather for 4 actions. So what I usually do is sneak a shinobi through to the end, hit the button, and try to kill all the enemies, or as many as enemies as possible, in this 3 turns effectively that you then have of free reign over them. So we want to have in this squad people can potentially do that, right? Who can do a lot of damage to targets that are just sitting there and taking it. So no Overwatch spec doesn't make any sense because they don't take any actions. So what's always worked in the past, and I'm not sure why I'm not seeing him. Oh, because they are, we've got people in this squad. Let me just go to squad soldiers, get everybody out of here. I was going to say, both barrels of Ranger is always good for the network tower, but you're injured for 3 more days. And your bondmate is Esther. That's a little bit of a conflict of officers. Okay, maybe we don't take you for network towers and at all. Alias is specialist, also not a good choice. As much as I like the interface, this being cut off on the right hand side is not ideal. Anyway, so I think we're gonna go with Frankie, Trench Gun Assault, Killer Instinct, so we can run a gun in there and probably delete a whole squad. Because they're all stunned and hopefully not activated yet, so they still be clumped up. Then I'm thinking, kind of completely ignoring all the bonds here by taking soldiers that are not bonded yet. Shooty Ranger with some potential for both barrels, etc. Then I probably want Sharpshooter. Could go Sharpshooter Gunner. The problem is Gunner doesn't really do anything yet. Once we get to Master Sergeant and we have Saturation Fire, then we can delete a lot of stuff. That's planning for the future, yeah. So that would put us all the way down here. No, you also have rapid targeting. You're supposed to go into officer training, by the way. Do I only have 2 Death from Above snipers at the moment? And Andy's tired for 8 more days. I can't have my dream squad or like any kind of squad that I really want for the network tower at the moment. Okay, you know what? Long term, I don't think technical is a good pick for the network tower, simply because the flamethrower damage kind of falls off later into the game, but for now the enemies are still weak enough that the fire can damage them sufficiently. So yeah, you know what, I'm gonna put you in here. Kind of setting up the network tower without setting actually up the network tower here. That's what I'm trying to do. So this is gonna be our network tower squad. And I'm gonna build the rest of the squads off camera, because it's gonna be a lot of me umming and ahhing, and I don't wanna comment all on that. Right. Again, squad names. If I don't see any comments with some name suggestions, I'll come up with something that I think is witty and everybody's just gonna groan. But that's fine. What else? Just wanna take a quick look. Can I take a quick look at this without going into the launch screen? Not really. I don't see a sitrep here, so I hope it doesn't have one. Like, if the network tower is created with the vigilance sitrep with increased detection range, that's gonna be a problem. Alright, so what we're gonna do, I think I'm gonna wait for the Stunlance autopsy to get the better sword in, and then set up the squad for the network tower and build squads in general. I guess we can wait this long, right? Also means we have our mission finishing. Fantastic.
My people understand the value of our cooperation, Commander. The Elders see us as nothing more than raw materials for their design. We will take back our power and turn it against them. I greet you as an ally, facing a shared enemy. My followers seek balance with the psionic forces that flow through the Earth and all its inhabitants. We channel this energy, aided by technology of our own design, to pursue justice for those who have fallen victim to the Elders.
It's fine, Geist.
And their servants. With our success comes the opportunity for you to assign us new orders, Commander.
Okay, so you're gonna get renamed, because for some reason, why did you not? It never shows up as the one soldier we have. We have one Templar in the pool, never shows up when we get a Templar. I'll fix that. Okay, gain one focus whenever your squad activates an enemy pod of size 3 or more. That seems really... That's gonna really help the Templar. So this has been reworked. That's what I'm kind of having a sneaky gander here. Become a god. Massively increasing your dodge, rend damage, and mobility. Grass Feed Focus consumes it all. Storm Reaper in the baseline, so you can always get them. Terrorize. It's panic to enemies hit by Volt. Are you trying to make a Volt spec happen here? Oh, Overcharge is different now. You get bonus aim and defense. You're right, aim is a thing now for Templars. You can totally miss with your rend. Blademaster Deflect is new bonus radius for Volt. Stun Solace. Okay. Invert is old. Reflect is old. That's all kind of old. Terrorize is new. That's the same thing. Center Mars. Oh, the lightning, like triggered lightning reflexes. Is that gonna be, that gonna count for Volt? I'm not even sure if Volt can miss. Or crit, for that matter. Bring him on, Implacable. That's actually gonna be a nice synergy, Implacable. Then you kinda can use your parry and still move. Don't give up your movement action. Alright, cool. I think we're gonna go Vigilance. Like, for me, that was always one of the biggest concerns. When you do think about an extremely light mission with like 9 enemies, by the time you actually build up your focus, all the enemies are dead. And you're kind of not helping as much as you could in getting there. I think there was initially, in the Long War of the Chosen versions I didn't play, this had not the restriction of enemy pots of 3 or more. So, like, you would get trigger 3 solo drones, you had 3 points of focus. Which I think was a little bit too strong. It's also going to be annoying seeing the focus animation each time you reveal a pod, but eh, what can you do? And of course, parry. Okay, we're gonna see how you fit in. I see a few potential bond mates on the left. So it's gonna be good. You have a psionic stat? I wonder if how that's gonna fit into all the things here. Let's carry on. Scan for this. Finish up the autopsy.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
Although Advent clearly intended for these units to be their means of dealing with any unruly civilians within the city centers, it seems they have come to rely on more brutal means of pacification in the time since.
Okay, go on, that's it for go. Extra melee damage. For focus generation, we have the channel ability. Okay, got a better sword. Got the normal Mark II gauntlets. Inspired mobile armor. No, I think we're gonna have to go for probably advanced mech weapons. Yeah, we need some alloys. So much for also building new stuff. Okay, assign research now. What are we gonna do? Well, not anything that costs alloys then, I guess.
Central officer,
just give the word and I'll get started, Commander.
All right, so these fancy new gauntlets, do they count as armor? No, I'm just being blind. Mage gauntlets, fears. And the better sword. I'm so blind today. Incredibly. It's one alloy for that. Like, even though on the network tower we're gonna have a stealth shinobi, I think we're gonna need. We wanna have a sword that he can actually do some damage in there. And that's our only Stunlancer corpse, and that's needed for all the gauntlets. You gotta be kidding me. Alright, so I'm gonna do a little bit stuff off camera. As I was saying, hang on, before I finish my thought, let's have a quick look where that mech went. I think it went here. No, it went up here. Interesting. So I'm gonna set up the network tower. I'm gonna build build squads for the whole team. And then I'm also going to continue scanning on the geoscape, and I'll bring you back in the next episode with whatever mission comes next, which might just be the network tower. We'll find out. For now, I'm going to cut it here. Thanks for watching. See you next time.